A thorough gentleman and an exemplary broadcaster. Tributes are being paid to pioneering television newsreader Philip Sherry, who died yesterday at the age of 87. Emily van Veldhoven looks back at his career.
The Cambodian government was rushing in reinforcements to hold the line against a big Viet Cong attack in the Mekong River area.
He was a familiar face at the end of every day.
I remember him as a terrific broadcaster, fundamentally one of the best I think that this country's ever produced.
Philip Sherry's precise diction first heard on radio station 2YD.
At 10:45, Feminine Viewpoint with Robin King.
Television arrived and he was among the first to read news bulletins. In the early 80s, he co-hosted with Tom Bradley.
Pictures the Television New Zealand brought to you every evening of the year.
People who watched him on TV would think perhaps he was a serious man, but he was, and he took his job seriously, but very funny. When the cameras went off, he had some wonderful dry humour, which he sprinkled about very liberally, and he was just delightful to work with.
Philip Sherry kept us informed for more than three decades, from events that shook the nation, like the Erebus disaster,
Captain James Collins, nor First Officer Gregory Casson,
to those reflecting change in our society.
New Zealand's first test tube baby has been born in Christchurch.
But then the influence of international media saw TVNZ opt for dual anchors. Following his retirement from television in the early 1990s, Philip Sherry became involved in local body politics.
He'll be remembered as a really, really nice man, a really professional man with the most beautiful set of tonsils and a wonderful voice.
You could have dropped him into any bulletin on the BBC internationally and he would have excelled because he was a classy broadcaster.
That class earning him both widespread trust and the nickname Mr. Credibility.
And that's the network news for Tuesday, the 5th of May.
Emily van Veldhoven, One News.